Jim Ross, okay, I'm in a weird camp. Now that Vince is gone, if they brought Jim Ross back for WrestleManias and shit, if Jerry Lawler, because Jerry Lawler is supposedly getting healthy again too, guys. I don't know if it's healthy enough
Christ.
To do all the events, but wouldn't it be kind of neat to see Jim Ross and Jerry Lawler together just calling one or two more matches?
Hey, how about you just have them intro the WrestleMania?
That's fine too. I'd love for them to be the hosts. Right.
Yeah. Just have them just go to the ramp, and you got King dressed like the 90s King, and you got JR with the cowboy hat, and there's welcome to WrestleMania. And that's all they got
to
do.
Well, not even just that. Dan goes, the mayor's right. He's like, let JR go home to WWE, have him do tape sit down interviews. The man is a human historian. Why right. in the fuck yeah. should he not go back to WWE? You're right. Even if he yeah. doesn't want to call live matches, maybe it's just an announced spot. But man, I would squeeze out every bit of voice I could get out of JR to validate any documentaries, anything that they put on TV, anything.
Yeah, I hate to draw a very blanket, cheap comparison here, but they're the closest living thing that the wrestling industry has to Gorilla and Heenan. Oh, so yeah. Yeah. Even like I said, to have them walk out on the ramp and say this, you know, welcome to WrestleMania, you know, blah, blah, blah. And that's if that's all you can get out of them.
That's worth it.
That's fucking worth it. That's worth every penny.
Give him and a by the crazy way, paycheck because you know he's worth it. You yeah. know he's worth it. Jesus Christ. Could you imagine Jim Ross being the inductor or the introducer for the Hall of Fame? Like,
yeah, that's
on.
Fine, too. Yeah.
Like, there's so literally, many things that they could do with Jim Ross that AEW just like, yeah, let's have him call this match. Like,
what if we have JR watch guys hit each other with pies?
Right.
He's maybe got two more years of any sort of like virality, if you even want to call it that. Right. So let's just completely waste his fucking life.
And let's be honest, WWE is going to treat him a million times better than AEW. And I don't necessarily mean how shitty the talent are supposedly backstage that show him disrespect that he's even spoken about. But I just mean in general, like you're getting a Hertz rent-a-car with AEW. JR might be going somewhere in a limo. You know what I mean? Right. Like,
which by the way, when times are tough and shit's a little meager, then hey, I'll take the Hertz rent a car. But
right.
now
but if you had a choice, Joe, what are you taking, the limo right. or the rent a car?
Right. Right. I mean, it's not hard, but no. Yeah, that's it. I'm hoping he escapes. I'm hoping that's it. I hope he's freed. Free him.
Somebody carries him with them to WWE in their arms.
Wardlow, pick him up, carry yes. him.
Wardlow's shirt is all burnt up and his leg, his fucking pants leg is missing. And Jim Ross is unconscious in his arms and he falls to his knees at WWE headquarters. He's like, help us.
He's just carrying a stoned JR on his back like Yoda.
Oh, follow Wrestling Soup on Twitter at Wrestling Soup. Like and subscribe to Wrestling Soup on YouTube. No. And check out the Discord for live chat during the shows at discord.gg/wrestlingsoup. Check out and subscribe to the shows on Apple, Amazon, iHeartRadio, Spotify. And more.